What's up, guys, and welcome to the channel. My name is Andy, or Andy for short, and I am a first year medical student at the Medical College of Georgia. As you can assume, studying is a huge part of my daily schedule as a medical student, and after about 7 to 8 weeks of figuring things out, I've finally settled on a study routine that helps me through the long 8 to 10 hour study days. And I want to share these study strategies and secrets with you so that you can implement them into your schedule to become the most productive student that you can be. Let's get started. Step one, I'm going to title First Exposure. For me, this starts at 8 a.m. and goes until 11 a.m. every day, and typically consists of me attending or live streaming my lectures. This is where I am annotating the professor's slide notes as he or she is talking, and I am recording my own written notes if the professor says anything that is not posted on the slides. I make sure to really highlight or bookmark any slides that the lecturer says will be high yield for board exams and any topics I'm confused about to go over later. Step two is cement and elaborate. Similar to your body's acquired immunity response, your first exposure isn't exactly going to do much but familiarize yourself with the content. But a proper response to the information is not going to happen until your second exposure to it. So immediately after my lectures, I am going through my notes again, this time in more detail, underlining key points, drawing out pathways, and elaborating on topics that I was confused about during the lecture. This allows me to have a stronger and quicker recognition of the day's topics while also reviewing the material days before any assessment happens. It is very important to do this review the same day as the lecture to properly cement the information temporally and spatially in your head. Step three is condense. After reviewing my lectures for the second time, I should have a pretty good idea of what is important in terms of clinical relevance or high yield board material and what is not. With that in mind, I then try to condense the topics I need to know. For example, specific strains of pathogenic bacteria, their related risk factors or clinical presentations, treatments, and treatment side effects. Then you compile it all into a Word document or flowchart so that I can have all the important information at a glance. This also helps you filter out the nonsense because, as I'm quickly learning, when the preceptors ask you questions about a certain topic, they don't want an encyclopedia entry about the bug. They want only what is important and relevant. So this step is great practice for the future pimping that will be done on clinical rounds. These quick facts and reference sheets are also super useful to store on your computer for future reference so that you don't have to flip through terabytes of notes to remember something you learned months ago. Step four is supplement. In med school, supplemental materials are all over the internet, and some med schools even arrange deals with third-party companies to give students subscriptions for a lower price. However, the materials are only worth it if you use it. My two favorite supplemental resources right now are Pathoma and Sketchy. Lately, I've been using Sketchy a ton because it uses drawings and storytelling to explain pathogens, antibiotics, antivirals, and so much more in a quick and fun manner. I am definitely a visual spatial learner, so I can use these pictures to tie information into locations within the drawing. I can't explain how many times this technique has helped me on quizzes, and honestly, resources like these make learning a lot of fun. Also, it is just really useful to have another person's perspective on learning material. What the lecturer thinks is important may or may not be the same as what an outside resource thinks, so having both perspectives will make you twice as prepared. Then finally, but most importantly, quiz yourself. Active learning is so important, and the biggest change between undergrad learning and med school learning is that you no longer can just get by with pure memorization. All of the information that you learn must be applied in a clinical scenario, and that takes a lot of practice questions. some of my lecturers give students practice questions after the lectures, which I would do a day or two leading up to my assessment, but the main source of active learning for me is Anki. All of the cards I use, besides the ones that I make myself, have tags on them associated with the supplemental materials I use. So throughout the week, after I watch a video on a certain topic, or I finish a lecture over a certain drug which is found within my decks, I would search them and then unsuspend them. This puts them in my daily rotation of reviews leading up to my assessment, so that way, every day I am reviewing my knowledge instead of just brain dumping it after I get done with the material. And I guess, little bonus tip, make these long quiz sessions fun. You're doing upwards of 500 to 1,000 cards a day, so get relaxed, turn on some music, and get your focus on. Some days I'm listening to movie scores because I think my high school lit teacher told me there's some research proving that the highs and lows keep your brain engaged, but I don't know. Some days I'm just trying to chill with some good lo-fi beats, but hey, then there are those days you just gotta turn up and enjoy yourself, because studying is only as fun as you make it. In total, this takes me around 8 to 10 hours every day, which is a grind, but that's what med school is all about. These are all simple study techniques of spaced repetition, distilling your knowledge, constant review, and outside supplementation that can be applied to any study routine, even outside the scope of medicine. Of course, all my study techniques right now are subject to change. Being a med student is all about being adaptable and being adaptable quickly. So as the months progress and different material is introduced, maybe there are better ways to study for that material. If that's the case, I'll keep you updated with another video. Hopefully you learned something and that you incorporate some of these study techniques into your routine as a stellar student. As always, if you enjoyed, like, comment, and subscribe. Support the channel. I do this as kind of a creative release as a medical student, but I would love to know that you guys are supportive of the content that I'm making and that these are hopefully helping someone out there. I post every week, so hit the subscribe button, join me on this adventure in med school. As always, stay motivated, stay healthy, and I will catch you in the next video. Peace. Lame, you can't tell the difference. One time for a who knows.